back, everybody. As most of you at home already know, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Now, one in eight of us women will be diagnosed in our lifetime.
Staggering.
That is a staggering statistic. Yep. It certainly is. Now, a few months ago, our very dear friend, our family member, really our sister, Kym Douglas, revealed her cancer diagnosis to us. Today, she's here, and she's healthy, and she's bringing us up to date on her health status, her recovery, and she's sharing with us what she discovered during her health journey. Please welcome our sister, Kym Douglas.
Aww. Hey, Kimmy.
Okay, so a few months ago, back in May,
yeah,
you chose to do something that was very brave. You chose to share with everyone, all of our viewers at home,
yeah,
that you had recently been diagnosed with breast cancer.
Right.
It was stage zero.
Yes.
That's a very big deal.
So great. No chemo, no radiation,
well,
nothing.
But still, a double mastectomy was encouraged.
Yes, and thank God I chose to do that because I have a team of all female surgeons and they went in for the surgery and the surgery was going so well and it was just easy peasy, you know, we're gonna be out of here by lunchtime, we've got this covered, it's gonna be great. And the very last scoop of breast tissue that they removed, dense breast tissue, they found attached to my chest wall right across from my heart, and underneath the dense breast tissue was a 1.5 centimeter tumor that was stage three. Oh.
That was not detected.
And they didn't detect it previous to
with,
that.
With anything,
MRIs,
she got everything.
Diagnostic mammograms, everything, biopsies, all of it.
So had they not, had you not have a double mastectomy,
they would never have found that.
Yes.
I mean, so then what happened after that? So you realized you had this stage three tumor. What was the next step for you then?
Well, you know, Cameron, honestly, just taking a step on that, you have to realize that at that moment, I really did look back and say, you know, if I hadn't gone through with this, with this mastectomy, it was very possible that this could have just grown and turned into me being someone that you hear about with lung cancer that's never smoked, or someone.
We sat in the office many times and you didn't want to do that surgery.
No, I didn't.
You were against it.
Yeah.
And the fact that you decided to do it is
a God thing.
Yes.
It's truly
a blessing.
God, because it could have gone, you know, all over. So stage three brings with it a high reoccurrence rate. So that is why my doctors put me on a very heavy-duty regime of chemotherapy, six chemotherapies, radiation, Herceptin and Perjeta, which is another drug, and then 5 years on a pill. So, however, I am cancer-free, and this is all to make sure that there is no reoccurrence.
Yes. I know. So you are cancer-free, and you're almost done with the chemo, but then you're going to start radiation as well.
Yes, exactly.
And that's another, a lot goes along with that. And I mean, as a woman, as a beauty expert, we're good friends. I know how much a career has meant to you, and you have built a career and such a beautiful career for so many years. You were, you know, concerned about what this chemo was going to do to your skin, to your nails, to your hair.
Yeah.
I mean, it was a big deal for you.
No, it is. If, you know, I know a lot of people at home watching have family members or they themselves have gone through it. And I will tell you that chemo will bring you to your knees. It strips you of everything you've ever held dear. You know, your eyelashes and your eyebrows and your hair and your body and everything gets taken away from you. But thank you, Shirley. But the good news is that you get a new understanding of what beauty really is. Mm. Because you know what it is? It's truly strength. And when you go and you find something out that you don't expect like this, you get a sense of strength that you never knew that you had. And I'm happy to share with our viewers and our audience that I'm wearing a wig right now, and I will for some time. But I'm here.
Yeah.
I'm here.
Exactly.
So, you know, that's all that really matters. And you do everything that you thought was important is not as important. And the things that you think weren't as important become so valuable to you.
You've lost 40% of your hair?
About 40% of my hair. I wear this little blue hat, which many thought was just a fashion joke.
It looks good on
you. Thank you, Larissa.
You pull it off.
With your green juice.
Tell you
yeah,
right now,
my green juice. I will say I've traded Diet Cokes for green juice.
Which,
okay.
That's awesome. A positive.
That's yes. A positive.
And it's called the Penguin Cold Cap. And you guys, it's really pretty intense. You have to change it every 20 minutes. And it's like an ice freeze. It's a freezing, freezing cold cap. You pull it way down over, you latch it around, and it freezes the hair follicles so that the chemo can't burn your hair.
Wow. Yeah. What a wonderful thing.
Yeah, and it's every 20 minutes.
And I just want to point out the fact we're talking about a lot of sort of the outer beauty elements. But as long as I've known you, you have been more beautiful on the inside than you are on the outside. And I just want to, and you talk about like emphasizing what's really important and what beauty really means. And you exude beauty, and it has nothing to do with your hair or your eyelashes.
So true,
I
got to
point that out
for sure,
coming from someone that knows you. So you talk about the mammogram and getting it, and in many ways, I think it's fair to say that it has absolutely saved your life.
100%.
And part of the reason, like you've alluded to, is that you're spending your time now raising awareness to everybody out there, but particularly about early detection, getting the word out for early detection.
Right, and you know, again, you guys, it's just that, you know, I haven't eaten meat in 35 years, and I don't drink, and I don't smoke.
You're so healthy, that's what's so
drugs.
Crazy.
I've been married to the same man for 150 years.
It's incredible
it's not
think
like
about
I'm
it.
Running around, you know.
Being wild.
Yeah. So all I say that for is that even if you think, you know what, I don't have it in my family, I'm good, go and get yourself checked. Do self-examinations, do sonograms, do thermograms, whatever it is that's right for you, just do it because you will be so glad you did.
I mean, I feel, and we both believe this, I feel God gives us what we can handle.
Yeah.
And I know at home right now, there are plenty of people going through their own pain and their own suffering. What would you say to people at home who are going through extreme challenges and are just ready to give up and quit?
Well, you know, Deb, I would say that you do have more strength than you realize. This entire situation has deepened my walk with God, deepened my faith, and for that, I'm so grateful. The people that have sent, the strangers that have sent letters and cards and notes and just Facebook comments, you have no idea how that has helped me through. Sometimes some of my darkest days where I just really want to be in bed under the covers with the shades drawn, but you are stronger than you think, and you can make it through. And that would be my message. Just put your health as a top priority, especially if you're a woman.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful message, Kym. Thank you. And I have to point this out to you because it's something else that I love is I know that Hunter celebrated a milestone birthday this past summer. It was a birthday that you wanted to make sure that you were there to see. And now, of course, you're going to be there for many, many, many more birthdays to come. But tell us about this special summer birthday.
Well, you know, and Larissa knows this for sure, but when someone gets diagnosed with cancer or diabetes or any particular illness, you know, the whole family gets it. Don't you agree? Mm-hmm. The whole family. And so when I got hit with this, it was Hunter's, you know, was starting a new life. And he's been, many of you know him since he was a baby. He was literally born on this show. And the first time around. And, you know, that was his second birthday. And then it was his 21st birthday. And so he had this birthday party where he invited a bunch of his favorite guy friends. And most of them are, you know, LA kids that are a little like, you know, they've seen it all. They've been around. They're a little
too
cool. And so they all wanted to get him, you know, something for his birthday that would really, you know, matter and he'd like. And they ended up all pooling their money together, $1,695.47.
Oh, my God.
And it all went to breast cancer research.
Look at that.
And that was Hunter's birthday present for his 21st birthday. And I will tell you that through all of this, I have learned strength and how to fight and how to be a survivor from him. Because from day one, he just said, Mom, you got this. You're going to fight this. You're going to beat this, and you're gonna get through. And I have, and I will.
That's right.
Will. Yes, you will. And that just goes back to how important it is to have family and friends around you at all.
all times, and how important it is to believe it in your head and in your heart. Kym, I love you so much, and thank you so much for sharing your journey with us, and thank you for being so brave. Thank you for being such a warrior, Kym.